Hello, today I'm going to show you how to create this camera shutter symbol. Let's open a new document and set the fill to none. Then press the letter L for the ellipse tool and draw a big circle in the middle of the artboard. Next, switch to the pen tool and draw a straight vertical line. Press the letter V to select the line. Next, we will move it to the right. Click on it, hold and drag. The farther the distance from the center, the larger the shutter opening will be. Now press the letter R for the rotate tool or select it from the toolbar panel. And while you are holding down the Alt key, click in the center to set the rotation point. Type 360 over whatever number of iris blades you would like to make. I'm going to create 6 blades. Now click copy. Then press the Ctrl and D keys on your keyboard to repeat the last step. Select everything, then go to View, Guides and choose Make Guides. To turn the guides off and on, press the Ctrl and semicolon keys on your keyboard. Next, select the pen tool or the curvature tool, whichever one you prefer to use, and create a curved line. Place the first anchor point on this intersection, next one on this one, and the last one somewhere on this guide. If you prefer curvier blades, move it lower. And if you prefer straight blades, move it up to the next intersection. Switch to the selection tool to select the line. And like before, using the rotate tool, click in the center to set the rotation point. Leave the angle value as it is and click copy. Now press Ctrl D a few times to make more copies. Switch to the ellipse tool and draw a circle the same size as the guide circle. If you like, you can always turn off the guides. Next, make sure that everything is selected. Then go to Object, Path, Offset Path. Highlight the number in the offset window and using the down arrow key on your keyboard, change the value to a negative number. Select everything, set the stroke to none, and then go to the Shape Builder tool. Pick a color of your choice and single click on these areas to create blades. Next, open the sublayers in layer 1 and select all the gray shapes. Group them together and lock this layer. Next, switch to the outline mode. You will notice we've got a lot of unwanted paths. To get rid of them, select everything and press the delete key on your keyboard. Turn off the outline mode. And let's turn the guides back on. Next, we'll create this ring. Switch to the ellipse tool, change the stroke to dark gray, and draw a circle that is the size of the green guide circle. Then go to Object, Path, Offset Path, and change the value to about 36 pixels. This will be the center line for our text. Go to Object one more time, Path, Offset Path. Leave the offset as it is and click OK. Let's select the middle line, change its color to bright yellow and give it a name. Now lock the type layer. Select these two circles and go to the Shape Builder tool. Select dark gray and click on this area to create a ring. Let's lock this compound path layer, which is the dark ring, to prevent it from shifting. Then select these two layers and delete them. We won't need them anymore. Next, we will add text. Let's turn off the guides, unlock the type layer with the yellow circle, and make sure it is selected. Now select the Type tool and choose Type on a Path tool. Then click on the path. And if you wish, pick your desired font, increase its size, and change the fill to white. Now type your text. If you would like to learn more about how to type on a circular path, please check out my other tutorial. I've included a link to it in the description. Next, select the path, double-click on the Type tool, and make sure the Align to Path option is set to the center. If you would like to change the color of the blades, first select this group and then use a darker gray. Let's undo it. With this group selected, we could also go to Object, Path, Offset Path, change the offset to about -4 and add a darker gray to it. Experiment with different offset values, color, and see what works for you. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.